Now, Ohio health leaders are concerned about this growing impact of the COVID-19 Delta variant, specifically on kids. And this comes as schools prepare to reopen for the academic year. So we have Dr. Frank Esper, a pediatric infectious disease specialist from the Cleveland Clinic. He's joining us this morning. Thank you so much for coming in and discussing this.
It's very good to be here, Natalie.
So the American Academy of Pediatrics saying about 19% of these new cases are youth, they're children now. It seems that we're seeing Is it just that we're talking about it more? It just seems like we're seeing more children being affected by this Delta variant.
I think we are seeing more children. And in the beginning, parts of this pandemic, it was only about 5% were individuals under the age of 20. And now we're getting closer to 20%. It just shows that the virus has changed to the point where the children are still a lot more resilient to being infected and being sick. But this new variant has changed to the point where it is able to overcome a lot of that resilience, and they're able to cause more infections in children and more sickness in children.
So I know we're not trying to alarm anybody, but this proves to be a point in time, I think, for parents to be terrifying because their kids at a certain, they're not getting vaccinated, they're not able to get vaccinated, but yet they're around possibly unvaccinated adults. They're heading back into the classrooms. A lot of fears going on. How do you address those? What would you tell parents?
Well, there are still a lot of children who can get vaccinated if they're 12 years or age or older. And so the older children who were always the ones who were more likely to get more sick than the younger children are still more or less likely to actually get infected. Still. Anybody can get infected and anybody can get sick, and we want to protect everybody. So what you can do is continue to work with those strategies of, even though your child can't be vaccinated, you can be vaccinated. If you're the parent, if you're the adult or older children around that child, you could be a ring of protection. By vaccinating yourself, you protect the youngest in your household as well as yourself. In addition to that, when you're talking about going back into schools, and I know a lot of schools are still working out that there are a lot of strategies in order to minimize the way that this virus spreads in the school, and they will continue to use those strategies of masking and distancing, all the hygiene that's going to go into this school year coming up.
So from what I'm gathering, then, hearing that the Delta variant is affecting children clearly more so than the previous. So we need to be taking all these extra measures that you're saying in order to protect them. What about, I know you're highly involved in this, so when it comes to herd immunity, mm-hmm. when it comes to where we're at 50% right now in the state of Ohio, right. as far as vaccinations go, what are your thoughts on where we need to be with herd immunity?
You know, herd immunity is a moving target. And unfortunately, as this virus changes, the goalposts change. In the beginning, we thought that we needed somewhere between 50 to 70% or so in order to achieve herd immunity. And herd immunity is basically when this virus is no longer able to easily spread throughout the community. You reach that herd immunity, the virus numbers start to plummet. Unfortunately, if the virus becomes more and more infectious, now we need not 50 to 70%, but it's going to be closer to 60 to 80% or 70 to 90% or something along those lines. In the beginning, we talked about the infectiousness number. It's called the R-naught. It says how many people get infected by one person. If one person got infected at the beginning of the pandemic, it led to two infections. Mm-hmm. And then those two infections led to four infections, and it goes on and on. Now that infectious number is 5, more than double.
Wow.
And these scales are more like the Richter scale. It's not linear. So 1 goes to 5, 5 goes to 25, 25 goes to 125, 125 goes to 600. You could see how that R-naught at 5, or this infectious number at 5, is so much bigger than 2. And that's why we're starting to see a much bigger push, and why we feel that we really need to double down on getting people vaccinated, because everyone who's vaccinated is like a stop sign to this virus, stopping and preventing its transmission from going on and on and on. And that's why we really need to work on getting everybody vaccinated.
Well, it is a pleasure. Your wealth of knowledge, clearly. Pleasure having you on this morning, Dr. Frank Esper with the Cleveland Clinic. Thank you so much for being here.
It's good to be here.
And
thank
educating
you.
All of us. We, you know, there's a lot of fears right now, so you help, I think, to just put things into perspective for us.
Sure. Happy to do it.